Yes, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. My name is Mr. Jabera Matogoro. I work as assistant lecturer at the College of Informatics and Virtual Education of the University of Dodoma, Tanzania. Today, I would like to give a short presentation on community network and why it's important. Community network is an approach to empower the community in addressing their local challenges related to connectivity. Community networks, community members own the network and are also responsible in deciding the price of internet access and hence create business viability in a rural area. It is a bottom-up approach and it's a feasible to connect and connected. Why community network matters? It's because it is a feasible approach to connect and connected, especially in rural and underserved areas. Community members, especially in rural areas, have voice to connectivity-related matters. It would also work better as compared to the current top-down approach, which is currently being used by most of our telecom operators and most of governments around the world. Well, telecoms are reluctant to rural areas due to the fact that return on investment is not realized in a short time of period. Because as you know, most of our telecom operators are much interested in making business. So they are much possible and interested to invest in urban areas where return on investment is always realized in a short time of period. And community network work better if affordable solution is available. So the University of Dodoma is currently working on the possibility of using the TV white space as the middle mile and last mile solution for the community network. And what is a TV white space technology? TV white space make use of unused UHF spectrum band, which is planned for the digital terrestrial television. For instance, in Tanzania, UHF spectrum available for digital terrestrial television is ranging from 470 to 694 megahertz. So why TV white space and not fiber, not Wi-Fi? Of course, for the fiber solution, especially in mountainous area, then you find that higher installation costs will be required to raise the infrastructure towards end user premises. But for the, why not Wi-Fi? You know, Wi-Fi covers a small size, a small cell in size. So you find that it can even hardly cover around 200 meters. So in a very larger geographic location, that means you need more access point to cover larger geographical location. And Wi-Fi propagation characteristics of Wi-Fi, for example, 2.4 or 5.8, in most cases work under direct line of sight. So if line of sight is not available, then it's not a feasible solution. But for the TV white space, because of its propagation characteristics, then it becomes an affordable and a best solution, especially in location where there is high mountains or big trees, high buildings, because the UHF spectrum band, UHF spectrum can penetrate those kind of obstacles. However, it's a feasible solution in most of our rural area. You need also to take into consideration that before deploying the TV white space solution, you need to also get a permission from the local regulator. For example, in Tanzania, it's the TCRA, or Tanzania Communication Regulatory Authority, is the one responsible in governing the spectrum usage in Tanzania. So the, this is an architecture of connecting three sites where you have a base station, and the base station is connecting to the backhauling solution like a fiber. And the base station gets a channel to use from the database. So the University of Dodoma has developed a database which is taking care of issuing the channels. This, you know, database concept is very important, especially in handling harmful interference to the digital terrestrial users. So you can see that we also have a sector antenna that is covering 120 degree. So for the 360 degree, you need around a three sector antenna to cover 360 degree. So you can see that, for example, in Dodoma, we have a test bed, and the longest link we are covering is about 4.6 kilometer. So you can see that with TVO space, it's possible to send a signal from one crest to another around 4.6 kilometers. And this can even cover to even 20 kilometers, depending on the geographical location and terrain of that location. So TV white space with affordable and a feasible a broadband technology or solution, then it address connecting and connective. And this is the way we are encouraging other community members to start thinking of this. And in order to make sure that that's project or such kind of initiative successful, then you need us to build the skills or technical know-how on addressing various issues from cell planning, network planning, and even making sure that the throughput that you are interested with is achievable at the end users. So this is a very short script or short presentation on the community network and the TV white space, and would be appreciate to respond any question, any kind of support you may require from us. You can just drop an email to us, udomtvwhitespace@gmail.com. Thank you.